Hello friends, we are going to solve this problem, insertion sort part 2. So in the part 1, we have inserted only last element to its correct position. But in the second part, we have to arrange all the array in sorted manner. So we have to work from left to right, that is, we have to sort the array from left to right. We have to check the conditions for the insertion sort from left to right. So what we have to do is we have to traverse this array from left to right as in the first part. N is the number of elements in the array, and ARR is the actual array we have to sort. So that part is same. So if you are not seeing that first part and have not solved that first part, insertion sort first part, please watch that video. So you will get this problem better. So what we have to do is we have to traverse the array from left to right, and we have to check the condition if the current element, that is for the first element, the next element is sorted or not. So in the first case, 3 and 4 in a sorted manner, so they have printed the same array again. So we have to move to the next index, that is 4. So we have to check that if the 4 and 7 is sorted or not. So they are also in sorted manner, so they have printed the same array again. And in the next condition, we have to check this 7, and we have to check the next element to it, that is 7 and 5 are in sorted manner or not. So in this case, they are not sorted, so we have to swap those elements. So in the third iteration, you will see 5 and 7 are sorted, that is swapped, and they are in a sorted manner. So in the next iteration, we have to check the 7 and 6. So they are also not in a sorted manner, so they are swapping the positions. That is, in the next iteration, you will see that they have swapped positions. On the next iteration, what they have done is 2 is taking the first index position, and 7 is taking this 2's position. So what is happening here is condition is checked repeatedly, that is 2 and 7 is checked once, and again this when 2 is taking the 7 position and 7 is taking 2's position, then the condition is again checked with the 6, that is when 2 is here at the 7th position, 2 will again check the condition with 6, and if they are not in sorted manner, again they will swap positions so that 6 will come to this position and 2 will come here, and again 2, as our 2 is here now, so again the 2 will check condition with this 5. Again they will swap as they are not in sorted manner, so again 2 will check condition with this 4. Again they will swap. Again, they will check the condition with 3, and again they will swap. So in that way, this 2 is swapping positions and coming to its sorted manner, that is first position. So on the next iteration, the 7 and 1 will check the condition, and as happened with 2, 1 will swap position with every element and will come on the first index. So in that way, we have to solve. So in this problem also, we have to just print the array on each iteration. So in that way, we have to solve. So I'll go to the function. So you can check that whatever I explained in this sample output and sample input example. So they have explained pretty well here. So I'll go to the function. So in the function, what we have to do is we have to traverse array from first index to the last index. So for that, I'll use a for loop, that is for j equal to 0, j less than arr count minus 1, and j plus plus. So this is our for loop to traverse our array from first index to last index. So we have to declare this j first, that is int j. And after that, what we have to check is we have to check if the current index is sorted in with respect to the next index. So for that, we have to check if condition. If ARR of J is greater than ARR of J plus 1. So if this is true, then we have to swap the positions. But if this is not true, then we don't have to swap the positions. So think about this problem. So whenever this 3 is greater than any number, then in that case we have to swap the positions. So in this case, this 3 is greater than 2. So on the this fourth iteration, they are swapping positions somehow. I'm just telling you for the example, but they're not swapping. 3 and 2 is swapping positions on very last part. So that is the problem here. So we have to check this 6 and 2 actually. Whenever this 6 is whenever any number that is current index is greater than the next index, then we have to swap the positions. We have to check again with the next index, that is 5. So here also 5 is greater than 2, so again we have to swap the positions. So 2 will come at this location, so again we have to check with the next index. So again 2 will swap the positions, and it will check again and again again till it is in a sorted manner. So we cannot use if statement here, but we as we are checking again and again, so for that we'll use a while loop. And we cannot also use the J variable here because we are using J variable for this outer loop, so we cannot use that also here. So we are going to use I variable as I is also not defined. We have to define it here, declare it here, and this I will be starting with J. And what we have to do is we have to swap the two numbers. So for that I'll take a temporary variable and I'll be storing the value of I, error of I, in the temporary variable. So that also we have to declare here, that is temp, and again error of I will be equal to error of J plus error of I plus 1, and again error of I plus 1 equal to temp. So these three lines will swap two numbers, and as we have to check again and again till the first index, so I'll just give the modification for this while loop, that is I minus minus. So for this particular case, that is 2 and 7, so this while loop is very useful. So on the other cases, it will just go, it is going to check the conditions, and it is going to enter in the while loop only when the next index is greater than the current index is greater than the next index. So for that, this while loop is very useful. And after that, what we have to do is we have to only print the variables, that is array. For that we'll use another variable, that is k equal to 0, k less than error of count minus 1, and the modification for k. And just the printf statement, percent d x specifier, and then error of k. And as we have to print everything on the next line, so I'll just give a printf statement and the next line character here, that is slash n. So in this way, I guess it will work fine. I'll just run the code. Oh, sorry, I forgot to include, that is declare k here. So it is giving me error. So in now it will run okay. So some cases are falling. Have to check why they are failing. I think everything looks okay. They are getting sorted, but there is some problem in printf statement, I guess. Everything is perfectly fine. Oh yes, I don't have to gear error of count minus one, so that's why it was failing. So I'll run again. So here you will see that everything is fine and the first two test cases are passing. So because I've gave error count minus one, it was not printing the last element, but here we have to give error of count minus one because we are checking the next element in this while loop, and when you give error count and not error count minus one, then it will give some error because it is going to go out of the limit of the array, and that's why I've given error of count minus one here. So that we don't have to give here because we have to print all the array and all the elements in the array, so that's why it was failing. So once I corrected that, it is running fine for the first two cases, and I'll just submit to check all the conditions. So all the conditions are passing. So this is the code for solving this problem. So do let me know in comments. So and I have to tell you one more time that why I've used this while loop. So we have to check the condition of the current element to the next element. That is in this case of two, we have to check the condition again and again, again and again. That's why we have to use this while loop, and we cannot use the if statement, and that is why I've used it this while loop. And it will start from the jth location, as we have to check the jth location from the array. So that's why we have to use the while loop here. So thank you for watching.